run it back, run it back, run it back. Hey, how free to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my number's going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, J. Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look.
Okay, Coach, well, we are about a $50 cab ride away from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the New York Jets. This is fielded at the goal line. And a terrific return as they finally do stop him, but not before he's inside the 15.
And that's the type of return that puts a tremendous amount of pressure on the defense now. They've got to go out on the field almost like it's a sudden change, almost like it's a turnover. They've got to go out there and try and stop him. But, boy, what a tough spot they're in.
On first and 10, McKee. Eluding the pressure right. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
X3, 218, chop.
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They don't want to waste his outstanding field position on this opening drive as they come up on third down.
Bravo!
From the gun, McKee. And he's got McCaffrey open, complete. And he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down marker. A nice tackle coming up from his free safety spot.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Jets take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. Pistol, it's Bell. gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Second and 11 now. Darnold, he's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And he will find his man on the outside. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. On 4th down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. This is taken around the 12. And call that an even 50 yards on the punt with 7 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And, Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. Now this throw caught left side, and he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
Set, 10-2 start. Get that quarterback, D-line. Get that quarterback, D-line. D-line, get that quarterback. Watch chopper, chopper. And ready?
On first down, McKee. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got a bike. He just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play. Bear in mind, that wasn't a big lineman back there for the tackle for loss. That was a cornerback.
So are you saying the myth has been shattered? That all of them are not just cover corners? Some of them actually will stick their nose in and tackle when necessary? That's what we just saw, isn't it?
Second and 6. This complete to Jones. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. This Jet defense so far standing tall. They need another stop now, 3rd and goal.
I'm coming after you. Tighten up.
Twist on Travis.
Switch. Check 99.
Blake, He dripped.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead grows to 10-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Jets take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Ten nothing the score after one on EA Sports. Second and 13, Darnold. There he goes, left side. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers.
Now that was a beautiful play, a pick six. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What do you mean, with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Darnold going to lead the Jets up now. First and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll start out on the ground with Bell, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
On second and 7, Darnold, he's going to loft one deep left side, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 28, and he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. That one good for 33 and a first. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. McCaffrey. And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And a rout is on here in this first half. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and would you also have to guard against it?
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. That pick six extending this lead even further. And boy, it's been a while since I've seen a team struggle this badly in the first half.
I think all they want to do is get to the locker room, try and regroup, and come out to start the third quarter. But if things don't improve fast then, I think the backups get a lot of play in the second half.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And they gave up the pick six. And now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around? And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Dante Jackson picks it. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. This game really becoming a one-sided affair. Pick six there. It's in danger of being over before halftime.
And that's going to be a major league test for both of these teams, because, look, you feel like you've got this thing locked up, right? But on the other side, in the other locker room, it's going to be a test of pride now. Forget speeches, forget adjustments. What kind of pride do they have to start the second half?
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that, because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there. It's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. The shotgun snap for Darnold. He's going to float this one deep right side. And now here is another interception. Dante Jackson picks it. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. 53. Ready, go. Another run, this time McCaffrey. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Got it. So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action.
Let's go, let's go!
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business.
And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Carolina. A great play there. With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and a rout is on here in this first half. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off near the 32. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
This offense has had a lot to like in this game. I don't know that that last play, though, is going to make the highlight reel.
It's not going to make the highlight reel, but it will be the focus of the film session that the team has to sit through. I've sat through those before. Never any fun. You're always excited about your good plays, and they actually fast forward through those. All right, that was good. All right, great. They get to the bad ones and really illuminate them. Not cool.
It gets them a little over half of what they need, and now they're looking at a third and five.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
36. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will be knocked down hard, but he will have the first down. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
On the set.
53, check 53. Here we go.
Tonight, Lee Griff.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned,
under pressure now, Darnold, and he goes down. Brian Burns in there to bring him down, and that is sack number 17 for him now on the year. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Here's Darnold. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. Brian Burns in there to get him. And that is now sack number 18 on the season for it.
After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Mike's 50. Mike's 50. Watch the run. Watch the run. Watch the run. Pick the edge. Pick the edge. Come, come. Jim, 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 Jim. Whip, 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 whip. Watch the whip.
The lady.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. you're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
18 gain.
53. Mike, 53.
Okay, double up. Double up. Ready? You did it.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. They'll run with McCaffrey. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and they've got a ways to go now on third down.
Ready up.
Throwing on third and long. McKee. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down. Well, the crowd doesn't like that. Was going to bring up fourth. Now it's first.
They don't like it at all, do they? It brings them back into it, but really not in a positive way. Now they're angry. That can jangle a team a little bit as well. Pass interference ruined that series of downs for them.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And the reinforcements come in as they're gonna stop him behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
When this offense gathers to watch the tape, they're going to like a lot of what they saw. They put up big numbers, but they might fast forward through that last play.
Oh, there won't be any fast forwarding, partner. I've sat in those sessions before. You end up spending more time on the bad plays than you do on the good ones. It's just the nature of coaches. But I know sitting in that room, when you've had a big game, the night that they've had, you don't want to hear that. You just want to focus on the good stuff.
To throw on third down, McKean. It's caught, Jones. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 40.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Come on, set. 60 outlaw. And we're pretty quiet, D. We're pretty quiet.
Lightning. Now whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. The full start backs him up five. First and 15. McCaffrey following the penalty. Got some real estate inside the 30.
That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Set, ready? 60 yards.
Mike, rip left, rip left.
And up go.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. 4 yards on the pickup, it'll be second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Down! 10 Lobo!
Mike, number 53! Mike, 53!
We own it!
Go!
Now a handoff here to his running back. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And the Jets offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it first and 10. The New York offense taking over for their next possession.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
And that's going to do it. Clock hits zeros. They're not going to get another playoff. Time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Right there. Right there, right there. 54, Mike. Check pass, check pass.
On second and 9, Darnold. Under pressure now, Darnold, and he goes down. Brian Burns in there for the sack, and he's closing in on the all-time record. That's number 19 on the year. Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack.
It's going to be a long day.
Mike 50, Mike 50.
Watch the screen, watch the screen.
Let's go, Mike 50, Mike 50. Know your job.
He's coming, he's coming, he's coming. We got double up, double up.
Hey, alert three, alert three.
From his own goal line, Darnold. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
Exit, exit.
Hey, hey, tight end's right. Watch tight end.
Three down, three down.
Darnold now to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. On first down, it's Darnold. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down.
Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
To throw on second and 10, Darnold. throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
I think this one offensively, this is one where you just say, let's move on. Let's not even watch the game tapes from this one.
Yeah, you might just want to throw it in the trash, act like it was never there in the first place.
Yeah, just say we're good. I actually have heard of a coach in the past who took his team out to the practice field and ceremonially buried the game film.
And now here is another interception. Picked off around the 37. The number seven, usually lucky here, not for him. Seven picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened six times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he had won a Heisman Trophy in college, so sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career, but when you're talking about one game, seven, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw seven picks. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Coming to you, coming to you.
Ready to go. Get it.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Now, what can they do here on second and goal? Three red zone trips so far have yielded two touchdowns and a field goal. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. And they take a knee. It's second and goal, back to the 8 yard line now.
Hey, 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 we got three down, three down.
And they'll indeed take a knee. They've been stuffed twice here for losses. Now it's third and goal.
I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming.
And they will take a knee here. So this one is over, a victory for Carolina. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for the Panthers, they keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 8-3 on the year. And they will head back home next week.